back, everybody. Leeza Gibbons is a passionate advocate for healthcare, and today she is here to help us understand dementia and to explain how we can care for our aging loved ones. Thank you so much for being here, Leeza.
Thank you.
Very
nice.
Leeza's in the house.
And for always having such great information, especially about Alzheimer's and dementia.
Well, it's important because, you know what, it can be very discouraging, and you can feel like you're sort of one step forward and two steps back. Yeah. But those of us who deal with someone with memory loss know that that's not a disaster. That's just a cha-cha.
Right.
And you just keep dancing.
Exactly.
You just keep moving as best you can.
So you have partnered with an organization called Senior Helpers.
Right.
And they break down Alzheimer's and dementia into GEMS.
Yes, they are experts in the world of memory loss. And so they provide care companions who really know how to manage this disease well. And so they have this care. This is a strategy for care wheel. And if you go to the website, they'll send you this for free. And I really like this because it gives you the characteristics of everything from normal aging all the way through to the last stages of dementia. And it will tell you the things that work and the things that don't work.
Okay.
For example, in normal aging, which they call sapphires, they assign a gem, which I think is kind of sweet.
Yeah, I like that.
Each stage is a gem. And they'll tell you normal aging, for example, people may get depressed because things are not working as well as they used to, for example. And they'll say that things that don't work for you as the care partner is, you don't want to get bossy. You don't want to assume that you can take charge. You still want to ask permission to help someone that's getting older.
Sure.
And as you move forward to the diamond, which is the early stage of dementia, in the diamond stage, you find that there's difficulty with change. And they may be losing time and place. Mm-hmm. And they may be repeating themselves, which is the familiar thing that I think drives a lot of care partners crazy.
You just said that, Mom. Dad, we just talked about that yesterday. It's that kind of conversation.
And when you look at strategies, Mark, for things that work, they will tell you don't correct, redirect. Right? So instead of saying you told me that already, it's going to be yes, and why don't we pull the drapes back? Why don't you help me sort out the silverware?
Sure.
So that's going to be something that's going to work for you in that stage.
And I like how, when we were discussing this earlier, how you were saying that it's the same way we give so much attention to our toddlers and our children from birth to 5 years old. We should do the same because the brain is changing.
You learn when your kids are little, you learn what works, right? And you learn why they're thinking what they're thinking. But when our parents are getting older, especially when there's memory loss and dementia, and Alzheimer's is just the most common form of dementia, there's so many types, we don't take the time to know that we have to join them in their world because they can't meet us in ours. So when you get to the late stages, which is Ruby here, and you get to the Ruby stage of dementia, and they're, you know, our loved ones are losing skilled use of their fingers and even their eyes and their mouth, and you have to take so much more time feeding, and maybe they can't understand your instructions, that's when they'll tell you on a dial like this, strategies for care, instead of giving instructions, maybe you're going to sing it. Because songs are very familiar. So maybe You Are My Sunshine is a familiar song.
Interesting.
Kim, please don't sing right now.
Sing with me.
I would.
It is your bath time. This is your bath time. Might be a great way to get your loved one to cooperate because that feels safe. Or if your dad was in the Army, you know, getting them to brush their teeth, you know, to the left, to the right, to the left, right, left, brush your teeth, brush your teeth. And any of those drills
cadence,
that's very familiar. It feels safe. It's routine.
Sure.
Just like with children, you're going to build a routine.
And it's playful, too.
Exactly.
It's playful,
and humor is a big, big thing.
What about one of the big things with our aging family members is driving. Driving is such an independence. Do you know what I mean?
Especially
it's like it is, especially for men.
For my dad,
it's my father was like that at the end as well.
Did you have to take the keys?
I did, and it was really one of the hardest things I ever had to do because we kept the car there, and he would go outside and look at the car every morning. But no, he couldn't drive it. But it was there. The car was there at least.
It's a heartbreak.
So what do you do?
Well, depending upon the stage, but in the later stages, it's almost easier to negotiate. Like, we never told my mother she could not drive. What we did instead was what I call a loving lie. We said, she wanted to have her keys with her all the time. That was comforting. That was the independence. But when she'd get to the car, we had disabled the battery. And so it wouldn't start. She'd come in and say, that darn car isn't working. We go, oh, Mom, let's call the mechanic.
Right.
The next day, she'd forget that the car wouldn't start.
Mm.
And so the same with her cigarettes. We took every match, every lighter away from the house, but she walked around with an unlit cigarette in her hands. Then we didn't have to correct her and be the police every day. You can't smoke, you can't smoke.
Right.
Sure.
But remember, most of our parents are from the greatest generation. Isn't she lovely?
Oh, Leeza.
My mom and many of our parents born before 1945, there's great pride, there's great respect, there's great appreciation for authority. So if you're having trouble with that conversation, take yourself out of it and maybe say, are you ever afraid when you're driving? Are you ever worried that maybe you don't see as well? Have you ever been lost?
Mm-hmm.
What does that feel like? Tell me more.
Right. Sure.
And then ask if they would like to go. I don't know, Mom, I think you're doing fine, but maybe you might want to go and to the DMV and maybe take a driver's test and just because I think you're going to do great.
Right. Yeah.
Or let someone else be the authority because they have great respect for people in authority. If a doctor tells them, if somebody else tells them.
That's, now you
lost actually
your
good
mom.
Life lessons.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think I'll just start on my husband when we get home. It's very kind.
It is very
such
kind.
A kind
no, it is
way
such
of dealing with things.
I will say, you know, you've brought so many wonderful lessons to us and ideas. One last idea, real quick, Father's Day.
Oh, Father's Day,
yes. A gift would be what? For somebody that you feel
you know, if your dad and my, look at my dad.
Dad.
My dad and I love to tell jokes.
He was on the show last time.
That's right, with his poem.
Yes, he's so wonderful.
He is so funny. I do always try to come up with a good joke for him because I can never top him. He's hysterical. He taught me how to bait a hook, so we'll probably fish. I like to try to do something with fishing and gardening. But for our parents that especially are challenged with memory, to bring back a time where they feel that they have the power and control, a lot of times that's movies, that's sounds, that's songs, that brings them back to a time when they were dominant and they felt powerful in their lives. Mm-hmm. So when you can put those things together, you know how they have now the old LPs and the old record players, right?
Get them.
So many things that you can do like that. But just to sit
an iPod or something.
For my dad, if he were still here, it would be polka music.
Polka music, exactly right.
That's what he loved. Aww. But he's not here. But what we are going to do next, you ready for this? A game of heads up. It is the American Summer Edition. You're going to play. You're all playing. And you're going to like it.
Whose team? Whose team?
Oh, yeah. Oh.